Hey guys, now don't be alarmed by the new character screen, we're not making a new character. This is purely just to make sure that I get the names I want. So I'm doing this earlier on in the kind of process of things, and then I'll fit this recording into when I need it. But basically, in order to get completion on some achievement points, it's necessary to do the personal story on all five races. Now obviously we've done the personal story on our Silvari, and that's our main character, but I'm also going to be making four other characters for each of the races just to make sure that we get all of that story done. And this also gives you a chance to see the character creation process of all five races. So let's see. Char. We'll do Char first. And we're going to make a Char male because I think they look better. And I've never really seen the point in doing a kind of female Char because they're very male-y looking animals. That's just personal opinion, but they just look very male to me. I don't see why anyone would do anything other than warrior like hard armor for Char because they're like so vicious and warrior looking. So I'm gonna do a warrior because I've personally never really played a warrior before. I've had warrior characters, but I've never gotten past level 20 because the gameplay is just very tanky, and I'm not a massively tanky person. I'm more of a DPS person. So let's do huge, since he's going to be, you know, like mean and grr. Okay, so then let's do physique. I kind of like skinny over big. Oh no, that one's perfect. That one's perfect. Still got that kind of lean build, but not quite so lanky. Now fur colour, it kind of depends what you want to do. Obviously you've got to pick a cat. I quite like white, but you've got to pick what kind of, like, snow leopard or snow tiger. Siberian tiger would be cool. I think we're going to do that. Pattern colour, I wouldn't do like black, panther black. Or do we do panther black? Do they have any other stripes? They do have this one. I quite like the whole Siberian tiger thing. Does it need to be that white? I might do a snow white. That's a bit better. More realistic, because Siberian tigers aren't white. Okay, head options. Head options, obviously, the hair. Hair, that's first. Oh, I don't know, they're all kind of ugly. That one's not too bad. I could just go with none. Oh, I quite like that. But that's quite a tribal, that kind of sticks to a theme for the rest of your gameplay. Not that we're going to be keeping these for very long anyway, because we only need them for those stories. I might play them, I don't know. Try and get all of my characters to 18 level and world completion someday. But we'll just make them for now and then worry about it later. Accessory colour, we've got to do as dark as possible. Face. Which one looks most ferocious? I like that one. That's awesome. His teeth are gnarly. Horns. Very important. The make or break a character. He's male. This needs to be like hardcore. I like that so far. That'll irritate me, it looks weird. Nah, hides too much of his face. Ooh, I can change him. I quite like it on the smaller side rather than the big side. We're gonna keep it like that. Face details, I mean, it's gotta have blue eyes. Not that you can see him anyway. Eye width, eye size. I don't want to change anything because obviously it's a cat. I'm going to get everything to look really strange, so I think I'll keep it like that. And then armored eyes. What is that? Well, their helmets don't actually suck. Like, that helmet's not that bad. I don't care about armored eyes since it's not really going to be played much. I wear a spangle helm. What's a spangle helm? A galia or armbands. I don't care. Ferocity. Okay, now this is where you pick your sect. So if you've been watching the Let's Play, you'll know that it's... There's three kind of sections that the Char belong to, and obviously the enemies being the Flame Legion. So the Blood Legion, which is straight into battle, front lines. Ash Legion, which is stealth and subterfuge. And Iron Legion, which is machinery. Now these all kind of correspond very loosely to the three Orders of Tyria. Obviously that being the Vigil, this being Order of the Whispers, and that being the Demon Priory. So I think what we're going to do is we're going to do Blood Legion Soldier, because I think that sounds better. Maverick is single out combat fighter. We are a warrior, so let's just do Maverick. I'm not even going to look at the other ones. A loyal soldier. Yeah. That sounds nice. Oh god, now this is the name fit. I want to keep these names so that if they ever introduce more races, that we have what I want, if that makes sense. Oh, actually, I don't know. I could do that on my other account. I might do that on my other account. Let's just do a Char name for this one. Okay, so he's a Siberian tiger. So... I knew it would be. Siberius... I don't want to do white, because it's so obvious. Siberius. Bear with. Right, it's going to sound really bad. Claw slash. I think there should be a cutscene. Yeah.
I am a Char. In this world of constant battle, I am the deadliest weapon of all. I respect no authority but the clenched fist of my legion. With engines of destruction, we have killed our gods. We reclaimed our homeland of Ascalon, and we planted victory banners on the graves of our enemies. Yet, if we waver, it could slip through our claws. Victory, at any cost. The Blood Legion is my mother. The Blood Legion is my father. We Char are born into battle. We live on the fields of war. And I will die fighting. I'm a soldier, a ground pounder, frontline infantry. I face the enemy head on. I've earned the respect of my comrades and forged alliances I can call on in time of need. In the Blood Legion, we're taught the meaning of the word duty. We are relentless. Today, the soldiers of the Black Citadel assault the ghosts that plague this land. I've been assigned to reinforce the bulwark. Let the Ash Legion strike from the shadows. Let the Iron Legion build its machines of war. I will not stop fighting until the only thing left standing on the field of battle is me. This is my story.
We look really cool. I was going through that thinking, like, if I ever make like a separate Let's Play of this, what point could I use the for the thumbnail? Getting around. Okay, WSD keys, move your character, use them to move around. Okay, I'm not gonna go through this because obviously this is like in concurrence with our actual Let's Play, so. What are you saying? Just in time, soldier. The Ghost Army's been bashing the gate for weeks. They've finally broken through. For the legions! Okay, now we're gonna do spam one bashing. How weird is it seeing this again after seeing Masteries for so long?
Hey, over here.
This is fun. I'm like loving the new character thing. Cool.
up so I can... I need your help, soldier. Tribune Brimstone has ordered me to the crypt, but I'm too torn up to make it.
What's so important that the Blood Legion Tribune is there?
The ghost of Duke Berettan is far more powerful than we thought. His army just broke through our defenses. Ritlock's about to fight him head on. If he succeeds, it'll be weeks before the ghost reforms, and we can rebuild our perimeter.
On my way.
Siberia's Clawslash is an amazing name. I think I outdid myself, personally. One of the benefits of having low-level characters and leveling them up whilst you've got your main is you can key farm for Black Lion chest keys. Join up with Ritlock, and this will seem very familiar because we actually just did it in our thing. So I might post this on part 100. Obviously, it'll already be part 100, so you guys will be like, why are you saying this as if it was the past? But basically, I'll do this as part 100 as like a celebration kind of thing. If I ever get to the point on the Silvari on my main that we don't need to do any more Let's Play on this, I will probably start another one with Char. Perhaps you can see how different it is, and you can see whether you prefer it to the Silvari, but perhaps we won't do so much world completion, or we might again, we might do that, but it might be a little bit of a refresher. A bit fun. I think there's achievements that you can only get through certain things, and yeah, it might be entertaining. I hate spamming one, Jesus. I don't know what colour to make his armour, like, main. You know how, like, our Silvari has, like, orange and black main armour colour? I don't know what we should make this white and black one. Because obviously white and black, we're in the Blood Legion. So I guess I could do, like, red and gold. But that's what we've already got on, and I don't really like it. Oh no, it's because it's mainly gold. I don't know. Fuck you! Annoying. This is so much easier than the dragon that you have to kill in the Silvari one.
Report back to Slumstead.
Don't you agree? That was so much easier. What the fuck?
If you live long enough. I heard what you did down in that crypt, soldier. Impressive.
Tribune Brimstone was calling the shots. I just did my job.
Don't sell yourself short. You were part of the team that took down Berettan and stopped the ghost assault. Smokestead is safe now, and you helped make it that way. People are still on edge, though. It'd help if they saw someone like you making the rounds, lending a hand. The quicker we get this place squared away, the sooner the Legions can get back to business. You can help. I'd rather have volunteers, but if I have to issue an order, I will.
That won't be necessary, Legionnaire. I hereby volunteer.
I think we look badass, that's pretty cool. Alright, so I don't know whether we should do some of the story now. No, actually, you know what, we're going to leave this here, and now we're going to go create the other characters ready for when we do the achievement points. So now we've done char, let's do human. And I think we'll do a female human. I like female humans, so that's fine. As far as humans go, I don't really know what to make her. Guess we could do a thief? Or a revenant? Revenant might be more interesting. Let's do a revenant. Gonna do kind of medium build. Physique. Gotta make her... I wanna make her fat, but... That bomb is ridiculous. Okay, she's having a normal body. Skin tone. Don't want her to be too... Yeah. Just kind of very white, but not too, like, pasty. Okay. Terms... Are these faces? Oh, the faces on this are, like, ridiculously weird. Some of them are really weird. Like... Which one? Oh, there's a really weird one, but... That! Like, wow. Some of them look really childish. I normally go for that one. I think I'll go for that one again, because it's the only one that doesn't look ridiculous. Hair colour. I'm not going a ridiculous. We're going to do brown, because it's just normal. Campfire's not too bad. I like that. I don't like any of these. That'll do. Oh, she's a warrior. She should really have a warrior hair, but not that. Ooh, should we go mohawk? I've never ever put a mohawk on any of my characters before. She is a revenant. Okay, accessory colour is gonna have to be gold because she's got red hair. But yeah, that doesn't matter. Eye colour. I like that. Awesome. We'll keep that. Right, Mist Scrim. I don't think I've ever done Mist Scrim. They all have kind of different things, but I don't think it massively changes a lot. Okay, she's a warrior, so I'm going to do that. In the streets, nobility. Don't be silly. Okay, I've never searched for my true parents, but that means that she wouldn't really be nobility, would she? Oh, I don't know. Balthazar is the god of war, fire, and challenge. They're also kind of in tune with the gods as well, though, I guess. Now, this is where we get names. I need to find a good name for her. So I'm thinking first name and second name. Normally I just do first names for humans, Norns, and Silvari. Well, most everything except for Char, that I do two names for. Alright. Orichal? That was a stupid name anyway. Hold on, let me have some time to think about this. Right, I'll put Bandradir. Oh yeah, Bandradir.
The human race once ruled Tyria. Now, we struggle to hold our ground. We've been defeated, driven back, and broken. But we will not surrender. So many nations have fallen. Only Kryta still stands. Our faith is strong, despite the silence of the six gods. With courage, we'll make our stand in Divinity's reach. The city is my home. I was born into luxury, a noble of Divinity's reach, and privilege comes with responsibility. I protect the commoners under my care. They believe in me. I'm grateful for their trust, and I will not let them down. Today, I plan to venture beyond the gates of the city and see the world for myself. When I arrived in Shaymore, I found the town under siege by centaurs. Innocent villagers are in danger. Someone has to help. I will show the people that we can triumph, that there is still hope. This is my story.
Ooh, I think that's probably one of the weakest ones. I didn't think that was particularly good as an introduction. I thought the Char one was a good introduction. Right, let's do this.
We're under attack. Everybody get to the inn. We can protect you at the inn.
You see how many humans are out here? Humans is like the most popular. Everyone wants to be a human. I suppose they just go with what they know. I'm a human. Let's be a human. Talk to Sergeant Walters.
Sergeant, there are more centaurs on the other side of town. Captain Thackeray's calling for reinforcements at the garrison.
If he's calling for help, it must be serious. But I can't spare anyone.
I'll go. Captain Thackeray's never failed Divinity's Reach. If I can help him, I will.
Balthazar, bless you. That's the spirit that'll win this war. Good luck.
Head towards the garrison. The music just cut off really. Okay. It'll be interesting to play these storylines eventually. But I hope that this episode has been a nice break away from the constant monotony of being the Silvari. So this will be nice, so we can just basically, well, let's run by a centaur. Yeah, so we will do all of these. We've only got the Asura and Norn left to do, and I will fit them into one episode even if we go over. So we'll do this, and then next episode I think we're just going to go back to our Silvari. When eventually we will come back to each of these kind of Char, human, Norn and things attacks, and we will do a bit more, but for now we'll just kind of do this for a bit. Oh, it's so much easier when there's people with you. So many. I'll tell you, three of us. I think everyone just like stays at the beginning for some reason. Don't know why.
Enough of this. I will deal with you myself.
You think you can defeat me?
So you can get really far towards him so that you appear in the cutscene. So look, we're right there at the cutscene. So you just basically jump knees to it. This is why I stand here, so when I get punted, I don't get punted away. So that I can just get back up and straight do this. Come on, you only have to do one hand as well. Thank you. Yes, I know. Treating me like I don't know how to play this game. Jesus.
Where am I? What happened?
You were injured when the elemental exploded. Captain Thackeray brought you here personally. You've been unconscious for 3 days. You had lots of visitors. Villagers you rescued, some seraph, even a noble from the city. He came by several times.
That'd be Lord Farron. He's a good friend. I'll check in with him once I'm fully recovered. What should I do now?
Fresh air and exercise are the best medicine. The goddess Duena helped you. Perhaps you could help others?
Thanks, I will. And thanks for taking such good care of me.
Bless you. You'll find plenty to do out in the valley. May Duena protect you.
Interesting. So that is that episode done. Now let's go back and do the Norn. So we've got those are ready and waiting for us, but let's continue in our special episode and do Norn. Now, I am going to do female for Norn. I think Char's going to be my only male. And as far as Norn goes, I wanted to do something that I haven't done before. So I've never made a Norn Mesmer, ever. I don't think I've ever made a Norn Mesmer. So I think I'm going to do a Norn Mesmer. I like Norns because they're big, so I'm going to make her bigger. She's got a really nice face. And a nice skin tone, so I don't think I'll change that. Bloody hell. They've made their characters a bit fatter, haven't they? I'm gonna make her tattoos white. I mean, that is mesmery, but it's just so tacky. They have quite a lot of different ones, but I don't like them all on her face. I mean, that's interesting. I like the huge ones on the back, but the arms will do. I think that is nicer, the subtle. Oh, that's nice. I like that. It's just, it's simple and it won't necessarily be seen all the time. I like her face, so I don't want to change her face. So I'm going to change the hair instead, and I'm not sure on that hair colour. Mesmer, I quite like blonde, I guess. Blonde. Orange red. Nah, my Mesmer on my other account is orange red. Platinum. I'm gonna go white. That's what I had on my original main on my other account. I can't have that again. I quite like the hair like away from her face because she has a really pretty face. What does that look like? That's nice. Obviously the textures on it are a bit shit at the moment, but that's just because we're in here. So let's do that. Accessory colour is going to be... Well, I don't know what colour I want her clothes to be. So it's going to be that. As far as eye colour goes, we're not going to have that. She looks like a vision in ice. I love it. Armour dyes. I'll keep them for now because purple's alright. Right. Mesmer mask creates an image I choose to look out from behind. A harlequin smile, a phantom of sorrow, or fang of dread. Never let them see with you without a smile. Let's go that one. And I'm going to go dignity because she's white and I'll remember blue on white. Cunning to protect the spirits. I lost an heirloom. Ooh, okay, this is really important. Do we pick raven, wolf, leopard, or bear? I picked bear for my main on my other account, so let's pick raven. Name time, bear with. Okay, Judacia, does that sound weird? I quite like the name. Yes.
I am Norn, hunter of the wild, born of the free and rugged Shiver Peak Mountains. In the far north, my people fought our greatest enemy, Jormag, a dragon of frost and snow. The dragon broke our pride, but it did not break our spirit. In our last hour, we heard the voices of four of the spirits of the wild: bear, raven, snow leopard, wolf. They called us south, away from certain annihilation. We founded the Great Lodge of Holbrek and claimed new hunting grounds. Some say we should not fight Jormag. I say the greatest risk is to wager nothing at all. One day, a hero will lead us home, and we will break the dragon's icy grip. I weave the skein of wisdom. My cunning confounds lesser foes. Like my ancestors before me, I seek glory. One day, I will take my place among the heroes of the Norn. The spirits of the wild have given me the gifts of trickery and cleverness. I challenge the skill of my enemy. I am the predator, they are the prey. I am still untested, but already my deeds have earned me friendship and great respect. Each year, a great hunt is called in Holbrek. Only the best among us are invited to participate. I'll prove my worth with guile, collecting trophies to show my prowess. Then I will drink and boast of my victories. I accept this challenge. I relish it. Come, danger. Come, adventure. In the lodges and halls of my people, my cunning will be remembered through the ages. This is my story.
Wasn't that great? I thought that was great. I love Norns. Let's go. One thing I'm doing first is removing that mask.
You don't want to miss a chance for glory.
You gonna start talking?
Hail, hero! Are you here to take part in this year's great hunt?
Of course I am. Just tell me what needs to be done and stand clear.
Hunt down the wildest animals you can find and take trophies from your kills. Present only the finest to Ido the Tanner to prove your worth. Whoever has the best trophy and whose bravery is the greatest will be invited to join the great hunt. Newt Whitebear has said this season's event will be one of the most dangerous, so be ready. I've even heard the renowned Erstigalkin might attend.
I look forward to impressing them both, after I've earned my place in the hunt.
Cool, and now we go pick one. I'm gonna go to this one that's directly this way. Oh, we're so slow. Oh, we're so slow. Oh, we're so slow. Actually, I'm gonna pick this one because it's closer. Vicious Dire Boar. This zoom is perfect.
You almost stepped in my trap.
Send your trophy to Ido the Tanner. Go away. It's so refreshing being in this Norn place. Like, I haven't been a Norn in ages.
Hurry up, Ido. I want to get to the moot before Kettle Keg Drainer drinks all.
Hail, Hunter. I'm the local leather worker. Ido's the name. Show me your kills, and I'll make them into trophies you'll be proud to show at the moot. Drinking, singing, and boasting. I love a good old-fashioned moot. Others save their parties for holidays, but I say every day alive's worth celebrating. Hey, Newt, look at this impressive trophy. Worthy of the great hunt, I'd say.
Indeed. You are skilled enough to defeat your prey, and wise enough to revere their spirits. You are worthy to join in this year's great hunt. By my own hand, I've brought the mighty worm Isormir. He waits above in the plateau for one such as you to challenge him. The great heir Stegalkan watches over him now, waiting for the hunt to commence. When it is time, you and the others will go to the high ground, over the valley. There you will face Isormir, and claim victory if you can.
I can and I will. This is where my legend begins.
Okay, accompany Heir on the Great Hunt. Oh, the hair bounces up and down.
Did you see the one that charged me? He must have been 20 feet tall. Ale makes me want to hunt, and hunting makes me...
May Snow Leopard grant you swiftness and grace.
Could you give that swiftness to me now?
Walk with the pack. In the eyes of Wolf, we are all brothers and sisters.
That's nice.
Battle with the strength of bear.
Oh look, people here already. How did he bring an ice worm up here? Come on.
Don't forget about the weapons. They're dangerous too. Don't let Garm have all the fun. He's reeling. Let's finish him off.
Kill Isormir.
All hail the slayer of Isormir. Now we turn to the Scorpion's Gate as no mere hunter, but a champion.
I like Air. Air's a good one.
What a hunt! I heard about your victory. Very impressive.
Thank you. It was a hard-fought battle, and I'm proud of my part in it.
An excellent beginning to your legend, friend. You know, a lot of folks around here have problems that need solving. A slayer like you could be a big help. Putting your skills to work sharpens them, and helping others wouldn't hurt your reputation either. Think of the glory.
I will seek out these problems and solve them. Then we will see how my legend grows.
Awesome. And the last one is Isura. So it'll be nice to have this full again, because I don't like having empty slots. So it'll be good to have this. Isura, female, of course. The Isura are so adorable. And I think I'll do... Oh, I don't know. I kind of want to do like a tiny little... I might do a guardian. We haven't done any in the medium category, so we need to do one here. He's either going to be a thief or an engineer. I guess an engineer would make sense since, like, they're Isura, I suppose. But I think a thief would be more fun to play, so I think I'm going to do a thief. I'm going to make her the tiniest thief ever. Physique. I want her tiny. Yeah, tiny. I'm going to make her dark so that she can like blend in with the shadows. Skin markings. She shouldn't have any skin markings. Okay, we'll do like very subtle skin markings. I quite like those, just the lines. Oh, and the back, that looks great. Head options. I can see a boat like that. Oh, that's so cool. I hate the hair for this. I don't know, black? I suppose black should go. First chance we get if we actually end up playing these is to get different hair. Faces. The first one is the nicest one. I mean, they're all aliens. First one it is. Ears, and you get to pick loads. Look, there's a really big floppy one like this, or you can do little ones like that, which I think I'm just going to keep. And eye colour, I want to be really green, perhaps? She's a thief, isn't she? I like the idea of a green thief. Let's do that. Armor dies, doesn't matter, so done. Okay, so it's important for determination, anonymity. Let's do subterfuge. Charm. Right, so you know the different colleges, so there's of statics, dynamics, and synergetics. I think we'll do synergetics, because it's green. Then we'll pick infinity ball, because it's green. Blip, because he's green. Okay, what should we call her? Hold on. Right, I started with Winky, but I know that's a slang term for male appendages. So I said it to Winkry, and it's got it. Yes.
I am Asura. I personify genius. My ancestors were driven from the heart of the earth, forced to live in this bright, wide world. Of course, we've excelled. We exceed expectations in everything we do. With Golem and Gate and Arcane Crystal, we have asserted our supremacy in this land and made it our own. We will not move another inch. Not for dragons, not for anyone. By studying the eternal alchemy, we can see that all things are connected. I am a scholar of interconnectivity and relationships. I belong to the College of Synergetics. Synergetics crews delve into the nature of fundamental coherence that many overlook and few exploit. My success positively impacts my crew, who then gratefully assist me, and I succeed even more brilliantly. Reciprocity. I've just been informed that defective golems, not mine of course, are causing havoc out in the jungle. Whatever the imbeciles outside the city have broken, I'll fix and make my name doing so. In time, I will map the fabric of connectivity that weaves us all together. This is my story.
Cool. There were so many screenshots on that I liked. Alright, let's get on. Let's get this over with.
You there. Get over here and fix this.
Rob. I'll see what I can do. Lots of people make Asuras as well. It seems, I think the Char was probably the least populated.
Pure chaos out here. Unacceptable. What's going on?
Just what it looks like. These golems have gone mad. Zoja suspects someone tampered with them. And by someone, she means the inquest.
Zoja's rarely wrong. Don't tell her I said rarely, by the way.
If it is the inquest, she's going to need help. Where can I find her?
At the malfunctioning gate that's spitting out these deranged golems. She claims she could feel them on the other side of the gate laughing at us.
Not for long. I'm going to help Zoja shut down the problem at its source. Thanks for the information.
Cool. Get to the portal. I'm going to speed past everybody because obviously we're at 45 minutes already. Even for a special episode, this is amazing. This little hog. Poor hog. Leave it alone. Oh, it's a boar.
She'll need your help.
It's not even working properly. It's malfunctioning. Oh, did I miss it? Oh. Didn't even get to fight it.
Hey, it's you again. I see you survived with your epidermis intact.
Of course. It takes more than a giant rampaging inquest golem to get the better of me.
Modest, too. Well, you've earned a dash of praise, if you ask me. The crews around the city would kill for the assistance of an inventor with your talents. You should ask around. Make yourself invaluable.
Not a bad idea. Thanks.
Okay, so that is it. Now if we log back out after we get rid of that ridiculous hood. And after we log out, now we can see all of the characters we have lined up. So we've got Siberia's Clawslash, we've got Bandera, Judacia, and Winkry. And I'm very, very excited to start it, but obviously in the next couple of episodes we will just continue on with Morticla's story, and then we will sort out where we're going from there. I think we'll do more Tickler for a while, until we've kind of finished all the story, and we might perhaps take a few episodes out to do a few story based ones on the other ones. So like we might take 10 episodes out to do the Char stories and leveling up that way, and that we might like mix it up a little bit. So I hope that is cool with everybody else, and thank you very much for watching.